today we're out here, Peralta Trailhead, doing the Weaver's Needle Loop. It's Peralta to Weaver's Needle, back down. Is it Bluff Springs?
Whatever's on the right.
The Bluff Springs Trail Loop. So it's gonna be a lot of fun. Can't wait to get out there. It's a beautiful day.
Oh, somebody's glove.
And there's a glove.
One glove. Oh, that's just
one glove. I mean, one glove. So what makes you think it's rocky, right? This is a real interview.
I know. It's
what gives you that impression that it's rocky?
One of those things that you just have this feeling.
Just this vibe out here. Yeah, baby. 1.83 mile check-in for Ray.
999 feet
to climb. I should have mentioned, we got to the saddle, the first view of Weaver's Needle at like 2.3 miles, a little under 2.5, 1,200 feet of climbing to get there.
It's me, I'm the problem, it's me.
At tea time, everybody agrees. Yeah, so another thing we didn't mention is once you get to that saddle, 2.5-ish miles, first time you see Weaver's Needle, you make a left on the trail. Going down to the left, we're gonna circle around Weaver's Needle and come back on Bluff Springs Trail. We think we will find out. Just hit mile 4. Section is very rocky. I don't know how many times I say that in these videos, but it's sketchy right here. Over 700 feet of descent. We just keep going down. Dude, are you okay?
I don't know. I might need to be airlifted out of here. This Yelp review is gonna be I'm gonna light them up. It's scratchy things. Come on, man.
No one makes me bleed my own blood. Nobody. We are 5 miles in. I got off the trail. We're still 5 miles in. I'm trying to find our friends here. It is absolutely gorgeous. Obviously, absolutely gorgeous because I'm out here. Oh! Oh,
zip, zang, zing.
So that was Peralta the whole time, huh? And now we're jumping on Dutchman now. So then we must take Dutchman to Bluff Springs. So we are a little over 6 miles, 6.3-ish. And pretty much exact same amount of elevation gain and loss, 1,400 feet-ish. And we are starting to begin another climb. Looks like out of this area and up around the other side of the needle. We get off Dutchman's Trail and do Terrapin.
Whatever right turn is.
Which, oh, well, so right turn this way.
This if we would have done that.
Ooh, we're getting scratched up.
Is that enough? Climbing.
Yeah, we're climbing back up. 18, almost 1,900 feet.
Get that on there.
Wow. Okay, here you go. Hit mile 8, over 2,100 feet of climbing. Terrapin Turtle Trail is no joke. The intersection, if you just did Peralta to Weavers, then you would cut down here, but
that goes to the needle.
Because of the needle, which we are not doing. We're going back to the parking staging area.
Oh, what?
Gosh, these rock formations are just so cool. It's hard to run not trip, but also look around at these formations. I mean, it's just wild out here. Nothing like it. You doing?
Good, we're going up there, right?
Going up there, yeah. It's crazy beautiful. We just hit mile 10. Yeah. And we're going through this kind of like boulder field area.
I think we gotta go
2,600 feet of climbing.
Oh, are we off?
Cut. Ray thinks we went the wrong way.
We are.
We're off.
All right, we are backtracking. So at mile 10, don't continue straight down whatever we're doing.
I'm surprised.
Go down there. Bluff Springs Trail, Peralta Trailhead. Okay, so when we turned around, we were actually at the edge of that. Come over, Sam, asshole. Just 26:48 for climbing. We have a little bit of a climb, looks like, coming up. Might end this around 28 or more for feet. And we believe it's about 12 and a half mile total loop, so we're getting close to the end. Which is sad, because this is so freaking awesome. Just hit the 12 mile mark, going down the final half mile descent.
Where's the finish line packed up already?
Yeah, boom.
Crazy coming down. Wow, you guys are flying.
All right, guys, what was that? 12 and a half miles, around 3,000 feet of climbing. Weaver's Needle loop.
More climbing than Steve.
What? Weezer's Needle.
Weezer's.